Hello, Chloe here, and I'm here to tell you some really cool facts about a really, really cool thing. Can you guess what it is? Well, our question of the day is, where do teddy bears come from? I hope you're ready to learn about one of the coolest, most loved animals ever. I'm willing to bet that you have one of these animals in your very own house. I would also bet that it sleeps in your room. These cool critters can be classified as official snuggleboats. Yes, they love to snuggle, huggle, and snooze. So today we'll find a little bit about the history of our stuffed plush teddy bear. As a matter of fact, I have one of my own that I want to introduce to you guys. Well, meet Teddy. Say hi, Teddy. Do you know where teddy bears come from? I mean, way back. Where do teddy bears come from? Someone had to think of the idea. Well, I did a little research because I wanted to know about my friend Teddy. And I found out that they weren't always around for kids to snuggle. I mean, can you imagine a life without a teddy bear? I know I can't. I would be far too lonely. But okay, here we go, way back in time. Teddy bears came about when Theodore Roosevelt was president of the United States. President Roosevelt was a hunter, but not always a good one. He went on a particular hunting trip and failed to kill a bear. I'm sure all the bears were happy about that. But some people thought they would help the president to go kill a bear, so they found a bear cub and brought it to him. The president was far too good of a man, so instead of taking such an odd gift, he didn't. He wasn't going to kill it. One artist named Clifford Berryman decided to draw a cartoon of the president with a little bear. I think they were making fun of him, because sometimes people do that when they don't understand others. Anyway, this cartoon made it into the newspaper known as the Washington Post. And after seeing the cartoon, Morris and Rose Mitchcomb got a silly idea. They made a stuffed toy that looked just like the bear in the cartoon and set it in their shop's windows next to a copy of the original cartoon. They named the bear Teddy after the president. And this was way back in 1902. Wow, that was over 100 years ago. Teddy bears have been around loving kids for a really long time. Well, at the same time, there was a lady named Margaret Steiff who lived in Germany and who was a retired seamstress with a soft toy factory. Well, she got the idea to make a soft toy in the image of a bear too. Now, Miss Steiff had made other stuffed animals like cats, me, elephants, pigs, and yet had never made a stuffed bear. Her nephew came one day and he had designed a bear for her to make. This was where the very famous Steiff bears came from. Miss Steiff, who was excellent at sewing her cute stuffed animals, would soon become world famous. Soon after these two people started making their teddy bears, people were buying them like crazy. I mean, who could resist such a cute stuffed bear? Apparently no one. Once these bears hit the market and more companies started designing their own ideas of cuddly bears, they became so famous. Look at how many toy companies now make plush bears. These bears also come in almost every color you can think of. Some wear cute clothes, some wear little bow ties, some wear hats, glasses, but they all have one thing in common. People love them. And kitties do too. Oh, but okay, then. People of all shapes and sizes, and even animal types, I guess, would love to just go hunting for the perfect stuffed bear to fit their personality, or the personality of a friend that they're getting the bear for. So, now that you have learned a little bit about where the first teddy bear came from, I guess you can just go out and get a bear and know all about it. Personally, I'm really glad that someone thought of making them. Life without them would be so boring. Teddies can be your best friend, your play buddy, your nighttime snuggly, and so much more. And they're always ready to listen to your troubles and share in on a funny story. And I'm glad teddies are so easy to find. Now be sure to give your teddy a big hug and maybe share a little bit of their history with them. I'm betting even a teddy would like to know where they came from. So, until next time, stay fuzzy, wuzzy, and snuggly, and be sure to hang out with your new teddy.